What a great day. The first day of a historic journey. Your visit, my friend Prime Minister Modi, to Israel. You are making history. We're making history together. This is a deeply moving moment for me, both in personal but also in national and international terms. Personal, well, I can tell you, I told this to Prime Minister Modi yesterday, that almost 30 years ago I went on a date in Tel Aviv in an Indian restaurant and produced two fine children. The food was great. So yesterday I asked Rina Pushkarna, who was the owner of that restaurant, to prepare this dinner for this date. And it was equally good. We also had a Meli singer of Indian origin. She sang a song hauntingly beautiful in Hindu, but also she sang a Hebrew song which the Israelis here are familiar with. It's called Ani Ve'ata Neshane Et HaOlam, You and I Will Change the World. I have a feeling that today India and Israel are changing our world and maybe changing parts of the world, because this is a cooperation, it's a marriage really made in heaven, but we're implementing it here on earth. We discussed in our meetings yesterday and today, just now, with several of our ministers and your delegation, we spoke about so many fields where we think we can make a big difference. A big difference in water, in agriculture, in health, in every field, in so many fields, in the fields of that affect the lives of our people, their well-being, their employment possibilities, the longevity of their lives and how they live it. So we have decided, because Prime Minister Modi and I are, I think, not only wedded to visions, but we like a big difference in water, in agriculture, in health, in every field, in so many fields, in the fields of that affect the lives of in these diverse areas by the 1st of January. So this is very practical. We're going to seek to bring to fruition these various areas which can truly revolutionize our relationship, but also the lives of many, many millions of people. Both in India, it's many hundreds of millions of people, but we're talking about beyond that even. We're talking about also cooperation in third countries and actually working together to better the future of the people of Africa. India is present there, Israel is present and coming into Africa, and we think that by joining forces in various areas that I just discussed and others, we can help the people of Africa as well. So this is very, very exciting, and it tells you how we are seizing the future. We also recognize that we are being challenged. We are being challenged by the forces of terror, the forces of terror that seeks to undermine our world, our countries, the peace and stability of our common civilization. And we have agreed to cooperate in this area as well. I have to say that from this meeting, we shall be meeting young Moshe Holtzman, who was a survivor of the horrible terrorist attack in Mumbai. And I thank you, Prime Minister, for making this important gesture. But this is an expression of our commitment to fight the bad and work for the good. And I think this is what marks this visit. It's a partnership to seek the good, to defend the good, to achieve the good. And this is a good day. Welcome, my friend, Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
Your Excellency, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, members of the media, thank you, Excellency, for your warm words of welcome and for the exceptional generosity with your time and friendship. I will truly cherish the most wonderful dinner that you and Mrs. Netanyahu hosted for me yesterday. Our conversation last night, meeting Mrs. Netanyahu, learning about your family, especially what you told me about your father, has taken my experience of your beautiful country to a whole new level. India admires the success of your people in overcoming adversity to advance, innovate and flourish against all odds. Friends, I'm honored to be in Israel on this extraordinary visit. In our modern journey, our paths have been different. But our belief in democratic values and economic progress has been a shared pursuit. This visit is an occasion to rejuvenate the bonds of our friendship, to compose a new chapter in our ties, and to jointly venture toward new horizons of engagement. Prime Minister Netanyahu and I have had productive discussions covering an extensive menu of issues, not just on areas of bilateral opportunities, but also how our cooperation can help the cause of global peace and stability. Our goal is to build a relationship that reflects our shared priorities and draws on enduring bonds between our peoples. Friends, Israel is among the leading nations in the field of innovation, water, and agricultural technology. These are also among my priority areas in India's development. We agreed that efficiency of water and resources use, water conservation and its purification, productivity increase in agriculture are key areas in deepening our bilateral cooperation. We are of one view that together our scientists and researchers would develop, build and implement mutually beneficial solutions in the field. Our decision to establish a bilateral technology innovation fund worth $40 million for research in industrial development will help us in achieving this goal. We regard thriving two-way trade and investment flows as the bedrock of a strong partnership. Prime Minister Netanyahu and I agreed on the need to do more in this direction. Businesses on both sides should take primary lead in such efforts. This would also be our message to the CEO Forum tomorrow. Friends, India and Israel live in complex geographics. We are aware of strategic threats to regional peace and stability. India has suffered firsthand the violence and hatred spread by terror. So has Israel. Prime Minister Netanyahu and I agreed to do much more together to protect our strategic interests and also cooperate to combat growing radicalization and terrorism, including in cyberspace. We also discussed the situation in West Asia and the wider region. It is India's hope that peace, dialogue and restraint will prevail. Friends, our people hold natural affinity and warmth for each other. The Indian origin Jewish community reminds us of these bonds. It also serves as a bridge to a shared future. In recent years, we have been receiving a large number of Israeli tourists in India. At the same time, more and more Indian students are choosing to pursue advanced academics and research in your best universities. I am confident that the strength of these links, old and new, will hold us in good stead as we force a partnership for the 21st century. Friends, around 150 kilometers from here, there is a slice of history in the city of Haifa in Israel. That is very dear to my country. This is the final resting place for 44 of the Indian soldiers who sacrificed their lives during World War I in liberate the city, that city. Tomorrow, I will travel to Haifa to pay homage to our brave Indian soldiers. Excellency Netanyahu, it has been a productive and memorable 24 hours in Israel. I'm sure the rest of my stay would be equally exciting. Let me also take this chance to invite you and Mrs. Netanyahu and your family to visit India. Wow. I again thank you for your warm welcome and hospitality. Thank you. Thank you very much. Shalom.
Thank you. And I accept.
Thank you.
ये है एबीपी न्यूज़ आपको रखे आगे.